Aptera solar electric vehicle total cost of ownership. A lot of people are hesitant to even look at purchasing any kind of electric vehicle because of the initial cost of purchase and because of the idea that electricity prices are going to continue to increase, or the fact that public charging costs are getting close to the cost of petrol or diesel, particularly for full-size EVs which have a large battery pack and need up to 100 kWh to fully charge. So in this podcast I am going to explore what the total cost of ownership for an Aptera might be and why it is going to be considerably less than either an ICE vehicle or a conventional EV. Firstly, we need to realize that the amount of money able to be saved by purchasing an Aptera will vary depending on how much you spend for your current vehicle and the number of miles driven on average in a year. So what I am going to do is just explore what it is going to cost for me personally to switch from my current vehicle to an Aptera, bearing in mind that I am probably not going to be able to purchase an Aptera here in Australia in the near future. My best case scenario is that at some point Aptera will build an assembly plant in Australia, in which case there will be no shipping costs involved in getting my Aptera home, as I will just go and pick it up at the factory, wherever in Australia that happens to be. Of course, if I were to order the launch edition, I am sure Aptera would make a vehicle for me that would be available in about 2025, but then I would have to pay for cost of shipping from California to Queensland, which is not going to be cheap. So I am happy to wait. The first thing I have to get out of the way is that regardless of what kind of vehicle my next vehicle is, it is going to involve a significant investment in the vehicle itself, as my current vehicle is a 2006 Toyota Yaris, which, reliable as it is, isn't worth much, but by the time I am ready to make the switch to Aptera, won't contribute much more than maybe $1,000 if I sell it privately to help finance my Aptera purchase. The second thing I am going to be upfront about is that the eventual purchase price of my Aptera is quite difficult to estimate, for a couple of reasons. The main reason is that while Aptera has prices listed on their website at this time, the general expectation most people have is that these prices will increase when production begins, because of inflation and supply chain issues that have occurred since prices were set a few years ago. The other reason is that I am enrolled in the Aptera referral program, and while I currently have 6 referrals which represent a theoretical $6,000 discount on my purchase, I have no idea how many of these people will actually follow through and purchase their Aptera before I do, or how many additional referrals I will get between now and then. So what I am going to do is assume that the difference between purchasing an Aptera and purchasing some other new vehicle is going to be negligible, even though, in the end my Aptera might cost me anything from $0 to $50,000 Australian depending on how many $1,000 referral discounts I end up claiming. I am probably not going to buy one of the higher-end models and may just get a 250-mile model, although having the 400-mile version would be nice for longer trips. An interesting point is that my current Toyota Yaris with its 42-liter fuel tank has a range of not much more than 550 kilometers, or 330 miles, so range is going to be either slightly more or slightly less than what I get now. What I really want to estimate in my calculations is a ballpark daily cost of ownership, based on current fuel and servicing costs, with a nominal cost for loan repayments, should I have to take out a loan to purchase the Aptera. Firstly, I will state what it is costing me to run my petrol Yaris, including any overheads such as oil changes, regular maintenance, and of course fuel costs. As a part-time Uber Eats driver, I am currently doing about 400 kilometers a week, and that is costing about $60. So that works out at about $8.50 a day. Over the course of a year I might do a couple of oil changes and other regular servicing costing maybe $500. That might increase if I need to have minor repairs done, but so far, I haven't had to do much apart from repair a broken transmission linkage which cost less than $100 and replace some coil packs, which I did myself, also for about $100. So maybe the total cost of fuel and servicing is $10 per day. Here's the thing though, all that goes away with the Aptera, because it doesn't need oil changes, and with the mileage I do, and the amount of free charging I can get from the sun, running the Aptera is basically going to be free. Sure, I can go out and buy a used petrol car for $10,000 if I have to replace my current car, but the thing about buying and selling cars is that although you always get depreciation when you resell, the more you spend, the more you get back when it comes time to resell. The beauty of an electric car though is that EV resale values seem to be very high. Even used Nissan Leafs, which are really obsolete in the sense that they really don't have much range and are nearing the end of their battery life, sell for a minimum of $10,000. Bear in mind that a Leaf has no solar charging, is useless for dorm long trips as it only has a range of 175 kilometers, and even if I am happy to wait for however long to recharge along the way, I will be paying the maximum price for electricity at a public fast charger. So, my conclusion is that whatever I end up doing, I will end up spending money, but with Aptera, I am investing in a vehicle which makes its own fuel from the sun and will likely have a high resale value because of its useful range compared to a comparable petrol-powered vehicle. For me it will work, because my current car, while it is a four-seater, rarely gets used in that role because it's only my wife and me, and mostly it's just me driving myself as I deliver meals. My wife has her own car, which suits both of us, as we can be out doing things independently and not be tied to the same vehicle. Who knows, if I get enough referrals from the Aptera referral program, we may even be able to afford two Aptera, which would be the perfect solution for both of us. We might even be able to tour Australia using the camping tent option of Aptera to free camp all around Australia, or pay a small charge to camp at a camping ground where power is included in the fees, covering the cost of travelling on to the next destination so we don't have to wait for solar charging. So, you may be asking, what is the total cost of ownership for Aptera? One thing I can tell you is that it has very little to do with fuel costs. It really has more to do with how much I am willing to invest to get a vehicle that will cost practically nothing to run. If I purchase the base model Aptera and it costs $40,000 in Australian dollars, that's probably a worst-case scenario, given that I can apply for an EV incentive of $6,000 from the Queensland government and can possibly even get a federal EV incentive if I purchase it as a business vehicle within a company structure. Hopefully though, with the help of my subscribers, who decide to order an Aptera through my referral link in the description box below, the biggest EV incentive will come from Aptera themselves, who are clearly committed to making sure that as many people as possible can get themselves into a solar-powered electric vehicle. If you too want to support the Aptera Challenge channel with your subscribe, your like, your comment or your Aptera reservation, please do so by clicking on the appropriate button or link below this video.